We are here in pre-war sanctuary, and I think I'm being mugged. Let me just time travel out of here.
Okay, that didn't work.
No, I'm just kidding. As you probably figured out, we are taking a closer look at the NCR Veteran Ranger armor today. It is made by Unoctium. As usual, I will leave a link to the download page for the mod in the description of the video. I am going to start off by telling you where to find it. The first location is in Kellogg's house in Diamond City, but you cannot access the armor if you haven't finished a quest that is connected to that house. If you haven't been in that house with Nick and found a secret room, you can't get the armor. So, if you haven't done that, the second location to find this armor is here, and that is the Lonely Chapel. The Lonely Chapel is just south of Sanctuary. So just south of Sanctuary here, you find the Lonely Chapel. And let's go and get it. You find the helmet here, and the visor, or the mask, down on the ground here, or it could be with the helmet. It was that at one time when I was here, and here is the coat. We are here on Spectacle Island, and as you can see, it looks a little different now, doesn't it? Well, this is the other material choice you have for this armor. If you're wondering, just want to mention, if you're wondering about my very cool bar here, that is a mod called, I think it was called Better Level 3 Shops. I made a video covering everything about that mod a couple of days ago, so you can go and check it out if you want to. I'll leave a link to that video in the description here. For now, it is the armor that's the center of attention. So let's head over to the workshops here, and we can check out everything. Let's start with the coat. It can be upgraded to have better damage and electricity resistance. The appearance you choose here. Here you have the Desert Camo, which is the green texture that I'm wearing now, or you have no material, which is the brown one. You can upgrade the gloves and the boots. The gloves you can make lead-tipped so that unarmed damage is better, but that's the only thing it doesn't do anything to the stats. The boots the same, it doesn't do anything to the stats, but it has different things that they do. Like the Deathclaw increases action point by 100, the Radstag decreases fall damage by 25%, and Yaogai greatly increases stealth when sneaking. Now for these things you need the very special leathers, which I'll show you how to make in just one second. This one needs Deathclaw leather, this one needs Radstag leather, and this one needs Yaogai leather, which are all components we do not have. Veteran Ranger Helmet. Here you can upgrade it to have steel lining, which gives it 41 in damage resist. The mask have different materials, same the helmet also has a Desert Camo version of it, but and it is a different, it's just hard to see, it's a little more brown, the Desert Camo, than the other one. Now, you see the mask have different visors, but these I really don't want to talk about because they're bugged. All these are bugged, and the bug is that in third person they do emit light, but you don't get any light in first person. You only get light in third person. And it said on the page that the toggable lights, you can't have both of them, the Pit Boy and the visor light, right? But the visor doesn't emit light in first person. another minor bug with this armor, and this goes for all of the components: the coat, the gloves, the boots, the helmet, the everything. All of them has this bug that follows. Okay, you saw now that I made the electromagnetic imager, right? So if I choose to infrared visor like that, I made the mod, right? So now I should be able to just switch to the electromagnetic imager like that, but see what happens. I have to build it again. So if you look at my circuitry there to the right, it's 21 and I need 2 to make it. Switch to the infrared. Now I have 19. So you see, it uses your materials too, and you get the mods. So if I go to my inventory now, I will have several electromagnetic imagers and I will have several infrared visors, but every time I wanna switch them, I have to build it again. So that's also a minor bug with this armor. So be aware of that when you make it. Be sure to know which one you want. So the simple visor, this visor, no visor, has no light emitting from the mask at all. It's just black. The simple visor, it gives you a little like warm yellow light from the visor. This one gives you a blue light from the visor. This one gives you a red one, and this one, no. Yes, it has a red one. This one is green, the night vision, and this one is also red. And this one actually works, because it is supposed to just give a light, and that's it. Emits a constant red light, and that's what it does. It gives a constant red light. The other ones here you can toggle. So I will now exit the station. I'll put on the mask. Here we go. So you see, I'm now wearing the mask, and as you can see, I can wear only the mask if I want to, but that looks like this. So it looks a little weird. But then again, you can use it with other helmets, which is cool. So I will put on the helmet too, and you see, it looks much better, doesn't it? Anywho's, now I will turn on my Pit Boy, and you see the eyes glow, and it actually emits a little light. You see it in the evening. I don't know if you can see it on the color there. If you look at the color of the jacket, you see it emits a light. So in third person, it also emits the lights onto the wall. If I go here, you see the light from the visor. You see it there. But in the first person, there is no light. So I take off, I'll take off the mask, and now my Pit Boy is working. Or, you know, I get light from the Pit Boy instead of the mask. That's more correct, isn't it? So you see it here in third person too. If I put on the mask now, see, now it's the mask that's glowing, not the Pit Boy. You see that? So what's happening is that you don't see the light in first person. It goes to all of them, and the effects that they're supposed to have is not also not working. It's bugged. But it looks cool. Really, it looks super cool. Really does. But the one, I'll show you that, the one that gives... it was a mask, wasn't it? This one. Voila. This one is supposed to just give a light constantly, right? And you see in the color there that it actually does, and you see on the wall that it actually does. And this one is supposed to work with the Pit Boy, and it does. So both of these give light, and it actually does give light in third person too. See? It works. And what's cool about this last one is that I can give it to my follower here. The mask there. Where is it? Up there. See? And he can have glowy eyes, so it's even more creepier. Yeah. Here is how you make the components. You go to utility in a cooking station. Any cooking station. You go to utility and there you'll find Deathclaw leather and Radstag leather and Yaogai leather. And what you need for these things are one oil, one purified water, one vegetable starch. And here you need Yaogai hide. Same up here, everything like I said, but you need Radstag hide. And the same here, but you need Deathclaw hide. You also need vegetable starch, and that you make here. Vegetable starch actually gives you adhesive, if you didn't know that. To find Deathclaw hide, Deathclaws don't always give you Deathclaw hide, but it's said that behemoths, the super mutant behemoths, they sometimes give you Deathclaw hide. Alongside with the Deathclaws, of course. So there you go. I guess that was everything covered. covered. So what I will do now is... look at that. It's cool, isn't it? That's the visor that's supposed to highlight the synthetics. The synths. Yeah, where was I? Yeah, I'm going to Diamond City. Before I go to Diamond City to show you where to find this awesome piece of armor in Kellogg's house, I want to read something that the mod authors has written on the page. First of all, upcoming update. New visor for consoles. New locations to find armor. Quick glance at the comments regarding some bugs. I don't have an Xbox, so I can't help with installation issues. I just want to say I did not have any installation issues at all. Regarding the light, you can only have one toggable light at one time. The Predator Vision light is not toggable, so you are able to either use the Pip-Boy light with that or another mod's light. However, the other visors are toggable, so they preempt your Pip-Boy light and possibly other modded lights. In version 6, I will reassign all the add-on nodes so they don't conflict with other mods' light. So you don't get a flashlight out of your boot, for example. So now you know that. And it did say in one of the comments here, I think it was, I can't remember where it was, but there it will be an update to this mod the 3rd of July, I think it was. So I think that, or hope that, many of these bugs will be fixed then. I guess the only thing left is to head over to, of course, have a beer here in my bar, and then head over to Diamond City and show you where Kellogg's house is and armor is located there. Here we are, Diamond City. I have the main entrance behind me here. So we just run down the stairs. And we take a left. Follow this little road here until we get to the detective sign. Here we have a set of stairs. You run up all the way up to the top and all the way to this door. Now this door is open for me. But if you haven't been here, it'll be locked with the master lock, and as I told you, you will be able to get in if you have a master lockpicking skill. The only difference is that you won't be able to enter that room, right? Because under here there is a button. There's a button which will not be there if you haven't done this part of this quest. And the armor will be located here. Now I cannot remember, I think it was this safe. I think it was here, it was. Not really sure. I think it was there, yes. It's inside this room. So, again, if you haven't done the quest, or, you know, been inside, you don't need to do the entire quest, but you need to start it and get to the point where you enter this house and you go into that room. So, that was it for this awesome piece of armor. And again, I super love it to death. I just wish that they would make these shoulders a little narrower for the female character. That's my only thing. Again, all of these minor bugs will probably be gone by next update. But until then, we can wear it and we can look super cool and have good stats, absolutely. So, as usual, people, go out, have huge amounts of fun, and thank you so much for watching.